What is going on, you guys? Brandon here, aka Brawadis, and today I'm here with
Phase Rug,
brother Brian. So, Brian, I've actually noticed we haven't made a video like just us two together in such a long time.
Yeah,
like,
I know.
You've been in my vlogs, I've been in your vlogs, you fucking pranked me with a snake, but we haven't just like made a video like this in a while. So, I'm glad to have Brian back in my videos. I'm sure you guys are glad to see him. And before we start this video, which Brian, just eat it. You already stole the candy from me.
Eat it. Wait, but one thing I have to say. For the snake painting, did I make up for it, like, with the room? I know my dad painted it and everything, but it was my idea. Did I make up for it?
Brian, I would have never been able to step foot in that room if the snake prank lasted any longer because I would have died. So yeah, thank you for the room, but it almost was never before seen with these eyes. So guys, before we start this video, which I'm sure you could tell by the title, it's going to be a crazy, crazy video. I just want to say congratulations to my brother for hitting 2 million followers on Instagram.
Thank you.
You're welcome, but I'm not done. And also congratulations to my brother who's almost at 6 million subscribers on YouTube. I could congratulate him for a bunch of things, but pretty much just know my brother is doing super, super big things.
Thanks, Brandon.
And they might just be numbers, 2 million, 6 million, but no, it's actually a sign of accomplishments. And well, my brother's doing really, really good.
So unexpected. What the hell? Thank you.
Because I need more footage because the video's going to be short.
But I hate you.
Anyways, guys, for today... Wait, are you going to say anything about me? Go.
I want to congratulate Brandon for 2 million subscribers.
Well,
it was like 2 weeks ago.
2.1.
And you hit 2.1?
Brian, I'm almost at 2.2.
No! Mm-hmm. Oh my god, congrats on that. Mm-hmm. Congrats on, you know, doing big things when you go to like the summer league, mm-hmm, and like meeting all these people and like you're doing a lot of big things, really.
Thanks,
though. Congrats.
Man. Thanks, man.
Like from when you started YouTube and shit, like I didn't think you would take it this far, but
yeah.
You put your mind to it, you put some hard work in. And this is what it leads to, like, Floyd Mayweather.
Bro, this story is going to be one that occurred right when we moved into this house. So that's actually not too long ago. Usually when we do story time videos, it's from years and years ago when we were kids. But today, the story that we're telling is, it just happened like less than 2 months ago. So as you guys know, we used to live in our old house down there about 20 minutes away. And we lived there for 17, 18 years. We lived there for so damn long. And so we finally moved into this
house.
Where
was this candy?
Brian, I told you it was gross. You still ate it. What did I say?
What the hell is it?
Tell them what I told you. I said water is going to squirt out. I don't know if you guys have tried this. They're called Zots. And
oh my
when
god.
When you bite them, it's like a like weird water sour that comes out.
Oh, go.
Okay. So we finally moved into this house. Beautiful, beautiful house, right? But as everybody who has moved before, no matter what kind of house you move into, or you know, if it's an upgrade or whatever, you still need to get some time to get used to it. You still need some time to get accustomed. So we moved here and I'd say first couple of days that we moved in my, no, it wasn't the first day that we moved
in.
It was
in, like the first or second week.
Yeah, no, it was the first week for sure. It was definitely within the first couple days that we moved here. So it's late at night and you know, I'm still getting accustomed to that. My mattress wasn't even here yet.
Yeah.
My mattress, as you guys know, I stayed in the old house longer than everybody else. So it took me longer to bring all my stuff here. Brian already had his stuff upstairs. So he was upstairs chilling on his bed. I don't know. This is so weird.
Like this, Brian, this is the weirdest thing ever. I don't know.
You're saying it's the weirdest thing. You didn't even have to experience it. You experienced the end of it. I had to experience the whole thing. So I'm downstairs, I'm chilling on the couch. For those who don't know, here, let's just show them really quick, Brian. So, Brian, are you okay? I told you not to take the candy, bro. Okay, so for those who don't know, this couch, sup, Dennis, this couch was not over there when we first moved in. This was before we got our furniture. Oh my gosh, I go down the stairs so fast.
Here, what the hell?
Yeah, just stay up there, Brian. You don't have the energy to go down. Okay, so these couches were not here because we just ordered these a couple weeks ago. It was that couch that was over there, was over here. So we had one couch. There was a
Hey
brother, how's it going?
What's up, dude?
Okay, so there was that couch over there and I was on that couch. So picture that, there was a couch here and then, okay, hold on. Keep that in mind. Back upstairs I go. That reminds me of the obstacle course. Okay, so now that you guys see,
visual representation.
Fine, how do I get tired that fast when I play basketball every single day? Okay, so now that you got the visual representation, so there was a couch downstairs, and this was late at night, I'd say around 11 or midnight. Wait, Brian.
You okay?
Mmm. This is the chocolate water.
I hate the Nestle water.
Nestle.
Wait, I think this one's mine though.
Okay, so I was downstairs laying on that couch because I didn't have any of my stuff upstairs. You know, just watching TV, whatever. It was super late. Brian's upstairs. My mom and dad are asleep. But my mom and dad were downstairs. They sleep downstairs. So Case in point is, I'm downstairs and it's late and I'm already scared. I'm already paranoid. Like, yo, it's my first couple of days in this house. I don't know what the hell anything is about around it. And I hear a really, really, really loud, I didn't even know what it was at the time. I heard a really loud noise. I'd say it was kind of like a boom, like just something, just, I heard a really, really loud noise and it was coming from like around the corner.
And then, I didn't hear it.
Yeah, keep Brian's upstairs.
I didn't hear shit.
Brian didn't hear anything. So Brian's upstairs and I'm downstairs. So I hear the shit and I get scared. I'm not gonna lie. It's our first couple nights in the house and I hear a really loud noise and it's coming from like, there's so many fucking entrances to this house. So it's coming from like one of the entrances to the house. And I get, holy shit, I'm like, what the hell? So I was laying down, so I kind of like sit a little. Like, now I don't stand up, but I sit a little. And I put the volume to the TV a little lower. And I was scared, I was super scared. And then, a couple seconds later, I hear a ding, like a glass, Brian, don't laugh, it's not funny when I think about it. I hear a glass break, like glass. So in my head, someone motherfucking just broke into the fucking house, and I'm downstairs. And and it came from right around the corner, right? There's a door that people, look, let me show you which door. Okay. Okay. So that door right where Dennis is cornered over, right there, there's a door. And I was sleeping, so there's the door, and I was laying down right here. So the door's that way, and so obviously in my head, I'm thinking, holy shit, someone just broke into our house. Okay, hold on, back to the story. Why did I run? God, now I'm sweating. Okay. So just to regroup really quick, I'm sitting laying down watching TV. I hear a little loud noise and I'm like, oh, what the heck, that's weird. Then I hear the glass break, so I fucking like get up, I start freaking out. In my head, someone fucking broke in, 100%.
And I still didn't hear this.
Yeah, someone like, someone slammed the fucking door and broke in. And so I start screaming, Brian, Brian. Now this is where the story gets funny. Bring me the gun, bring me the fucking gun, Brian, I'm gonna shoot. Listen. Okay. I don't own a damn gun. I don't have a gun.
I don't own a gun.
We don't have a gun in the house.
Not yet. Okay, I obviously heard that because he's screaming and he's like, get the fucking gun.
I'm trying to act hard. I'm like, get the fucking gun, Brian. Someone's here. Give me a fucking gun. I'm gonna shoot.
And in my head, I step out of my room. I'm like scared. I'm like, wait, what are you talking about? I'm like, Brandon, what gun?
This
what
idiot you says, this idiot says, what gun? How? I said, Brian, stop playing. Give me the fucking gun.
How am I supposed to know that? Like, how am I supposed to know you're being serious? I'm like, Brandon, what gun? You're like, get the fuck down, bring the gun right now. And I'm like, in my head, I'm shitting myself. I'm like shaking. I'm
in
like,
my head, I'm on? Saying this idiot. I'm trying. So in my head, there's a robber in the house that just broke
in
the
glass.
In
my head, I'm like, what is this idiot saying?
No, but in my head, the robber is 10 feet away. So I'm fucking standing up. I'm ready. You know what I do? I'm doing this with my sleeves. I'm fucking like behind the couch, but I'm ready. And I'm screaming, Brian, I'm gonna shoot. Bring me the fucking gun. Drop it down from the loft. And all you hear is this idiot. Brandon, what gun? What gun? And I'm getting Brandon, so mad. I'm
we
like,
need to practice for these scenarios or these situations, because how the hell am I supposed to know what's going on down there?
I don't know. I mean, Drake and Josh would have known. They would have figured something out.
Yeah, that's true.
But so in my head, I'm shitting my pants 110%. I'm hoping my mom and dad don't wake up, because their room was like, if they had woke up, the robber that I thought was in the house was going to be really close to them. So I was praying and hoping that my mom and dad didn't wake up. Brian Heach, that's whatever. That's Brian. But I didn't want my mom and dad. So I'm trying to scream to Brian, no, bring the gun, bring the gun. In my head, the killer's getting closer, the robber's getting closer, and Brian's just like, what gun, what gun? So then eventually, I hear Brian come downstairs. I'm like, yeah, bring me the gun. But in my head, I'm like, wait, Brian's gonna get killed. So I'm like, Brian, be careful, be careful.
I was like, wait, what's going on? I'm literally scared. I don't know what step to take. I don't know where I'm going. Cause like, remember, this is a new house too. Like, I'm like, wait, what am I supposed to do?
What was in your head when you were here? And I was trying to tell him, be careful. Cause when he started coming down, I knew he didn't really have
a gun. I then assumed like someone was in the house, or like you were like running from something, or like you needed my help. But I'm like, wait, what is going on? Like, there's no way someone could break into our house. We're in a gated community, but I fucking just walk down and like, I just like start walking towards your voice.
Yeah, so Brian starts coming towards me and I see Brian come towards me and I'm like, careful, careful, because I thought the person was gonna fucking kill Brian.
I was so like, I'm what like, is he saying?
So I'm still like trying to look at my Brian, toss me the fucking gun, toss me the gun, Brian, I'm gonna shoot, I'm gonna shoot. And I kept saying I'm gonna shoot just to scare the guy, obviously. But then in my head, I started thinking, wait, if I say I'm gonna shoot, then the guy, if he has a gun, he's gonna fucking shoot me first. So then I stopped saying I'm gonna shoot, but I stopped saying, give me the fucking gun, Brian, I'm ready, give me the gun. And so Brian comes downstairs and he's like, what is going on, what is going on? And I told him, Brian, shut up, just come here. And I grabbed him, I'm fucking ready. My mom and dad come out. I tried to tell them, we see them, because it's a the couch. I will show you guys downstairs, but my heart.
Yeah.
Right. So just imagine the couch. I'm like behind it, but you could see the hallway. And my mom comes out first. You know, moving her hair. She comes out, peeks in the hallway, and the door that the person broke in from is right like by the hallway. Yeah. So I'm trying to tell like, don't come. I don't want to say anything because, like, whatever. She comes out. She starts walking towards us. As she's walking towards us, she bends down and picks up like a...
Yeah.
Right here, there was a picture right here. She bends down and picks up like a broken piece of glass from the floor, and then with her other hand picks up like a frame. Okay?
You're so dumb for this.
If you don't remember earlier in the video when I went down to show you where I was sleeping on the couch, and then right next to it, I told you guys we had a picture hung up there. The picture fell off the wall while I was laying down. So here's what happened. I was laying down. The picture first fell off the wall. That's when I heard the boom. And then right after it fell, after like a second, the glass broke. It shattered. So that's when I heard the glass. So that in my head was first the boom was like the burglar trying to open the door. And then the glass shattering was like him fucking going through the glass. When in reality, it was a damn picture the size of smaller than this.
How did that like make you think that it was the actual door? Because if it was the door, it would have been 10 times louder.
I understand, but it's a new house. It was our first couple of days. I wasn't thinking. It was late at night. I was about to fall asleep. I wasn't thinking that. And I was so damn scared. And I'm like, what the hell is going on? So my mom comes, she's like, what is going on? Who did this? She thought like me and Brian broke the picture or something, and that's why we were screaming. And I'm just like, mom, hold on. Cause I still, yeah, the picture broke, but in my head, I'm like, wait, what if, you know, the robber made it fall? Or what if it fell by itself after the robber broke the glass? I still didn't tell myself it was just the picture. Cause you know, I was paranoid. I was not thinking that.
I was so confused, Brandon.
I'm sure, Brian.
If I was like, Brian, wait, I was scared. I was like, wait. Like, we're like backing up. Like, I was like, what is going on right now?
Yeah, so my mom's trying to stand there like, wait, what happened? And I'm telling my mom, hold on, come here. Don't go over there. But then I started kind of telling myself like, wait, I didn't want to say it in front of my family, but am I that stupid? Like, no, but Brian, you would think that too. Like, the first thing you would think wasn't something fell. If we lived in a house where there were a bunch of entrances and the doors were glass, and you would think that somebody...
Okay, but now this makes me think of something else. How the hell does the picture fall off the wall?
Okay, this idiot blasts music all day with the volume all the way up, and this house has a bunch of speakers.
Now, all around the house.
I'm just joking. We just probably hung it wrong because it was right when we moved in, so we just... I don't know. But point in case, the picture fell onto the floor. I thought it was a... whatever. My dad came out like 2 minutes later, and you know, I told my mom what I thought. I told Brian what I thought. Okay. But I told my dad, the man of the house, and he just looked at me like...
In disappointment.
Like, you're so dumb. And I'm like, Dad. No, he didn't really care that I thought it was a robber. He looked at me like I was dumb because I told him how I was like, Brian, give me the gun. So, I don't know.
Imagine what my mom and dad were thinking if they heard us.
I'm sure they heard.
Screaming and like... What the hell?
Guys, so I think, no, honestly, Brian, come to think about it, like, that moment was so scary for me.
I can't imagine.
I was like, okay, so right now, I'm lying. That's one thing. I don't have a damn gun. Two, when the guy hears me say, I'm gonna shoot, he's gonna fucking come in and shoot me first because I'm threatening him.
You need to think these things through, really.
Yeah, I need to think these things through when I thought there was a robber coming into the house. But no, I was ready. I swear, I was doing the Kevin Durant shake from the free throws. I was like, come here. I swear to God, bitch, come. I swear. But I just feel like I honestly didn't want to tell you guys this story because...
Yeah, I was like, why are you waiting till now to tell the story? This happened so long ago.
I know, but like, Brian, you told the story from when we were damn babies.
Because we didn't have YouTube channels where I would have told it like the next day.
Ah, okay.
Like, you know, we were daily YouTubers and we were like five. Imagine how many stories we'd have.
Every day our life was a story.
The vlogs would be so sick.
What were the vlogs be? You shitting yourself in the diaper?
And you putting me in the dryer and pushing me off the apartment window. What's wrong with this guy?
Anyways, guys, that was a story I wanted to tell you guys. Honestly, you could say, Brandon, what the heck? You're so dumb. How would you think that it was just a picture? But in the heat of the moment, when you just move into a house that you don't know anything about, and I'm downstairs pretty much by myself because my mom and dad were asleep all the way across the hall. I did think that. I'm not gonna lie. I thought that's what happened, and I don't even regret it. If that happened again, I would still think that somebody broke in. But now we have something else over there, which is not glass. So a shout out to me for, I guess, teaching a lesson to myself. I don't know. But oh, and shout out to Brian for almost ruining my life. What gun, Brandon? What
okay,
do you mean?
Now I know. Now I know. If anything else happens like
no, that, no. Now I know. I'm not gonna say bring me the gun, or else the person's gonna shoot me first. Anyways, guys. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I really do hope you guys enjoyed. Kind of a side announcement before I close this video. Yes, I will be going to SneakerCon Los Angeles or Anaheim, wherever, one of those two places. It's in Anaheim, but they call it SneakerCon LA. Either way, I will be there. It's a hoops classic, so I'll be playing in the basketball game. Woo! Ryan.
I'll be rooting for you.
I know, but did someone teach you manners? Like when someone's talking, you don't talk?
Sorry.
Okay, that's my man. I'll forgive you, brother. So, hold on. So if...
What are you saying?
I'm trying to remember. So if you are going to be at... Wait, hold on. Okay. So if you are going to be at SneakerCon, I can't wait. So if you are going to be at SneakerCon, I can't wait to see you guys. Ryan, shut up.
Just go.
So I'm gonna be at SneakerCon LA. For everyone else who's gonna be there, I can't wait to see all you guys. If you guys remember my vlogs, Brian, remember you liked my vlogs a lot.
The SneakerCon vlogs are lit.
Yeah, I'm gonna be with all those boys again, and I'm gonna get you guys some lit vlogs once again because my channel is dying.
Shut up.
Guys, I had one bad video yesterday.
I know, that's always like for YouTubers. Like they have like one to like three bad videos in a row. Oh my god, my channel's dying, including myself. So like, I don't blame you.
I had one bad video yesterday, which in case you guys didn't check it out, I will leave the link in the description down below. It was actually such a funny video.
Yeah, it was.
But it did like really bad in views, which whatever, that happens from time to time. And I went to Brian, I was like, Brian, my channel's dead. Like it's dying. I'm not a YouTuber anymore. So, yeah, guys, I'll be bringing you guys to your con vlogs. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please drop a like if you did enjoy. Brian, congrats on everything I told you in the beginning of the video. And subscribe if you're new. Guys, I
never... You copy my outro now or Brian, what?
Hold on, you think I was copying it before? Look what I was going to say next. I never, ever, ever say this, but I put my arm... Yeah, I was about to say, I put my arm on Brian's shoulder so it rubbed off on me. Turn post notifications on. Brian, I've never said that in any video. So this is the first time you guys hear it. So this is gonna be the first time that you guys do it. Please turn post notifications on. That's the bell, like
next to the subscribe button.
Yeah, like Drake Bell, the thing. Yeah, subscribe button. And no, really, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. And we are out.
Peace.
Peace.